Welcome to the pod. The boys are back in town. It's been a while, but we are back. It's been so damn nice.
It's only been a week.
And everybody's been so damn busy.
Has been a week.
That we haven't been able.
I mean, it's 75 degrees out, so.
But we are daylight.
Yeah, we haven't been able to get our brains together in the same spot at the same time to make this work. But here we are today. I am Nick Morota, of course. The man in sloth shirt is Boston
Connor. Hell yeah. That is me today.
Ty Schmidt repping his beloved New York Yankees. My Pittsburgh brother, Tone Diggs,
hell
wearing
brother.
His 412
apparel. Good to see you, brother.
Apparel. And in the back, of course, the lad of the lads at Papa Gumpino.
Hello, brothers.
Bruce Brown.
Brother.
And Mitt.
Hello, brother.
Love you, Mitt.
Love you, Mitt.
That a baby boy, Mitt.
That a baby brother.
That a boy, Mitt.
Nice outside. The first day of the year when it's over 70 degrees is just an absolute treat.
It's a game changer. We're all sitting out.
Let's just say I got a lot of playing outside to do.
Yeah, we do.
Throwing the football.
Drinking some beers.
I'm going to stop somewhere and buy a basketball and use my basketball hoop for the first
time. Are you?
Fuck
yes. Without a doubt.
We talking in-ground or?
Oh, yeah, in-ground.
Is it a gorilla?
Yes, you can. Yes, it is a gorilla. And yeah, am I going to lower that thing to 9 feet and absolutely yam?
Oh, you dirty son of a bitch.
Yeah, I am.
Duh.
8.5, maybe?
We'll see how the nine
don't
goes.
Don't hurt yourself.
I mean, if I want to, you know, go off the backboard and through the legs and stuff like that, maybe 8.5, maybe 8. Yeah, we'll see.
Boys, I know it's super nice out. We just talked about that, and we're all looking forward to getting outside. But has anyone sat on their fat ass and watched anything good recently?
Yeah. Thinking we have.
Can
you not say the movie that you're going to say?
Why? I just watched it last night.
Because it stinks and you know.
No. I see, you're wrong. I watched Spaceman. I watched Sandman's new movie. And I think I said this last week. Maybe I didn't. Maybe it was out there in the think tank. But I said, turn it on, watch the first 15 minutes. It was so fucking depressing. I was like, all right, okay. I'm not doing this right now. Last night, sun's out. Pretty tough for a movie to get you down when the weather's this nice.
Absolutely.
So I said, I'm going to watch this. It's awesome. Basically, the premise of it is that he is, you know, an extremely lonely man on a mission for this, heading towards this purple, like, haze, essentially, that's in the sky. And everybody on Earth is like, what the fuck is going on up there? So he is the guy they select to go check it out.
Okay.
And while he is on there, an alien.
What's his name?
His name in the show. So the main character that isn't him is the other alien, and he calls him... Skinny human.
Okay.
That's how he's referred to. And then
what's the alien's name?
The alien's name is
Gork.
Mamush. They named the alien.
That's a good alien name.
They named the man, or Hamush, excuse me.
The big Hamush.
Yeah.
Mr. Hamush.
Skinny Hamush.
Skinny human.
Skinny Babush.
Names him Hamush because he doesn't have a name. They don't have a name on the planet he comes from. Basically, he's referred to as Spaceman. That's why it's called Spaceman. His wife. It is a love story.
So they played David Bowie.
No, David Bowie. Yeah, there might
have
been.
Ground control to Major Tom.
There might have been some of that.
Feels like a movie they were going to play.
Yeah, in there. Probably should have.
Or Starman.
Starman. I might have missed them saying that.
Binder of the night. No, Starman.
Starman.
Starman. Waiting in the sky.
Yeah.
Yeah, that
all
one.
All good. They all would have played.
Yeah,
all the would've. Toughest part of the movie is that the alien is basically a giant spider.
I don't love that.
It's tough at first. When it first happened, I was like, all right, I'm just going to listen to this movie and keep playing video games because this thing is creeping me the fuck out.
Yeah.
Because I'm not a big spider guy.
Hate him.
But as the movie progresses.
Tarantula-esque, right? Not
tarantula-esque,
like
yeah. Okay. Massive spider. Kind
not
of like
a daddy long legs.
No. Kind of like Aragog from Harry Potter.
Okay,
if
sure.
You will.
Sure.
But it ends up being just an absolute spectacle. The Hamush is this alien that can trigger thoughts in the brain of the human.
Hamush can do that?
And see them, yes, and feel what they're feeling.
Oh, don't love that.
Oh, so an empath.
Hamush essentially...
An empath spider.
Hamush essentially becomes like
God.
Adam Sandler's therapist because Adam Sandler and his wife
having problems.
Oh, so many problems.
Oh.
Because obviously he's been in the space for over a year.
Yeah, it's tough.
She didn't sign up for that.
It's tough on any man.
It's always stuff. Having problems with his wife.
Always having problems. Yeah, I mean, shit, Uncut Gems. But again, it was great. By the end of it, I said this earlier. It was the most times I've paused my video game to watch a movie.
What video game were you playing?
I'm back in on Suicide Squad. While I was playing Suicide Squad, it got like too much. Sometimes it's too much. Sometimes it's like, hey, look.
Too dark?
Too much going on.
Too many bad guys at once, like too many hordes.
Intense. Okay.
Just wasn't in the right mindset. It's kind of like I didn't play Helldivers because of that.
I've been playing some Helldivers. A lot of hordes.
Yes, a lot of battles.
Is it the barbarian old?
No, it's bugs. like Starship Trooper bugs.
Yeah. What are you playing?
It's called Helldivers. You basically travel the galaxy and you go to different planets to defend them. Or are you taking over the natives? We don't know.
Is that an MMORPG or?
Not really an RPG. Third person. Definitely an MMO shooter.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. A shooter?
Yeah, next time you play, you need to tell me because I do want to play, but I don't want to play.
But so you can attack the bug planets, or there's the other side of the solar system galaxy where you attack the automatrons, the Autobots. Nick. They're all robots.
Nick.
And breaking news.
I mean, you've seen Men in Black. You always attack the bugs.
I personally enjoy killing the bugs more than the robots.
Yeah. Yeah. Robots are much easier to kill. Also, breaking out of Helldivers, there are now flying bugs.
Holy shit.
Yeah. It's getting intense. They just dump some game mode. It's real glitchy. Like,
yeah.
It's kind of shoddily
put
together.
That makes me not want to get it.
It's so many people are trying to play it right now, and I don't think they anticipate.
A lot of people are playing the bug game.
Oh my god! Yeah, when I first got the bug,
they changed the name to the bug game. Actually,
it's like if you took Call of Duty and Halo and smashed them together
with bugs.
With bugs,
it's like zombies.
Bugs Life.
It's pretty.
Bugs
fun
Life
game.
Is good.
Bugs
pretty
Life fun. Is good.
It looks sick. Not since we're on video games, Dune 2 video games coming out.
Okay. What?
Not Dune 2, but Dune video games.
Dune 2.
Yeah, yeah. It's gonna be sick. Kidding me? Riding fucking
the worm?
Yeah, I'm trying to think.
Don't
of his
spoil
name.
It.
I'm not spoiling it.
Come on, you gotta know the worm's name.
Chahalud, excuse me. Thank God. God damn. That
is that the name of all the worms or just one particular worm?
That's the name of all the worms. And then there are in Dune 2, they do vary, but they name all of them are named Chahalud.
They are.
Chahalud.
That's what the worms are. Okay.
Yeah.
You guys said, hey, you need to do it. So I did it.
Finally.
Shogun's fucking awesome.
Oh, there we go. Let's go.
It is so good.
Yeah.
Here we go.
It is so, yeah.
Who's your favorite character?
I think, I mean.
The Barbarian took a long time to die.
Yeah. Blackthorn.
Blackthorn?
It's tough not to like Blackthorn.
I like the guy who's
got
like.
Got savages.
I think he's not exactly the right-hand man, but he's
exactly
kind of the right-hand man to the king who likes Blackthorn.
Toranaga-san.
Yeah.
I know who you're talking about.
The piece of shit lord.
Yeah, exactly. No, that's... are you talking about the old guy?
No.
Okay, so there's the...
You're talking about the Yubushige!
There's the lord that likes Blackthorn, okay?
Yes.
And like...
Toranaga-san. Toranaga-san.
His right-hand man.
Yeah.
But it's not really his right hand.
The guy that was going to commit seppuku.
The guy, yes. Yeah. Thank you. Who fell off the cliff.
Yeah.
Yes, exactly. Sorry about your piece of shit, Lord. Yes.
One of the most ridiculous seppuku setups of all time.
I feel like I'm going to like that guy.
Yeah, he's awesome.
So I was going to wait until more episodes are out. You guys just think I should just watch
Last night, episode 4 came out.
Yeah, so I should wait until 7.
I'd dive in because it does, like...
You're going to need to turn the video game off, though, because you got to read something.
That's why I have waited, because I'm playing video games right now.
The good thing about it is you're also going to know, like, within the first 10, 15 minutes, I feel like, if you like the show or not.
You're definitely going to like it.
You do need to kind of just suck it up and, like, let... You got to get through the first episode because pilots are always, you know, like it's, I mean, and it is a lot of reading.
Which I don't mind.
No, not at all.
If you're
Squid
a dub
games,
guy,
I went Korean.
If you're a dub guy, apparently you can turn the dub on, but I don't.
Do
like
not.
That.
No, me neither.
Fucking do that.
No, I'm not a dub guy.
Zito suggested that, and I almost put my head
What's
through
that?
A wall.
You go no subtitles?
No, I go subtitles. I don't do the dub voices.
No, but you have the option.
Yeah, you have the option of hearing it in
It comes
English.
Out of the box.
Now we're
subtitles.
Talking.
Yeah.
You gotta
subtitled for you.
You gotta choose the dub.
Yeah, I mean it comes out like a normal ass show that is in a different language for some parts of it.
Yeah, which I can easily live with.
And like we've said before, they do the Portuguese in English.
Yeah,
so
Portuguese is English.
That makes it if the Portuguese was in subtitles as well, the whole show would be in
that'd be tough.
I was a bit confused about how that was working between the Portuguese and the English people. I know that
don't
they're
worry
speaking
about it.
English.
They just decided.
But how? Yeah, how would they communicate?
No, Blackwater is speaking
IRL.
Portuguese.
Yeah,
speak Portuguese.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yes. But you need to watch it dubbed because, like, someone will say something in Japanese and he'll be like, "What did that goddamn savage say? What did they say?" and then she tells him, "Yeah."
Yeah. Blackthorn's electric. Yeah. Just for him alone. It's
okay.
Worth.
No. I'm pumped.
What'd you do with my men, you goddamn savages?
I just beat Ghost of Tsushima.
Oh,
so like I'm all in
time.
On the samurai,
yeah,
and I just watched Shang-Chi.
Boom!
Same
great
thing?
Movie.
It's Chinese.
It's Shang-Chi, by the way. And yes, that is not the same culture.
And Nick just watched Beef. So
I did. Thank you for the recommendation.
So good.
It's pretty good.
So good.
Pretty good. They should have ended.
He
it
went
the,
holy
at
shit.
Nine.
Yes.
Yeah.
We said the penultimate's stuff. Always.
I thought it was the end, and I was texting Tony like, "Holy shit, what an ending! This is." And then it started rolling into the next episode, and I was like, "Come on." On man,
especially because since it's not
but the end of 10 is a little bit of
yeah.
Well, but since it's like True Detective though, and like the second season has nothing to do with the first season, it would have been
is
the right move. Yeah, yeah. The second season, they're following two couples.
Oh, we'll focus on a new beef.
Yeah,
I did not know that.
Yeah. So it's two couples. One of them is like a very successful couple. One of them isn't. The successful couple, I believe, is Jake Gyllenhaal and Hathaway.
Well, holy fuck!
Yeah, actually. And then
Well, in my mind, then I hope season one ended as a happy story for me.
Yeah, I could see that.
Yeah, I mean, kind of.
I could see that.
Some huge, huge pieces of shit, but yeah, I mean, they.
Yeah, terrible people.
Happy story.
Yeah,
but it was
died.
But it's a happy story.
It is a happy.
Glenn from
Walking Dead.
Walking Dead, good guy.
Okay.
Well,
maybe.
Sounds like he may be a piece of shit.
Turned into a good guy.
Yeah.
He turned into a good guy. Lady turned into a bad lady.
I watched Frozen and Dory for the first time this weekend.
Finding Nemo.
Frozen's top tier.
Wait, Finding Nemo. You watched for the
first
time.
Wow. I've never seen Finding Nemo.
What?
Really?
I'm too old. I'm not too old, but that was after my time.
Not even
Disney
with like the dogs though. Like I watched it because of my little brother.
I feel like. No, I don't. I never did.
Mikey
so,
Dogs probably had
Mikey
that.
Dogs.
So
if that got turned on, Mikey Dogs was screaming and yelling. For
that's
Godzilla.
One of those movies where Mikey Dogs stops what he's doing.
Yes.
And puts everything else aside. He's watching.
But Finding
no
Nemo,
one fucking text me.
And Frozen, right? Both incredible pieces of film.
Yeah.
Frozen.
They're
so
no Wreck-It Ralph.
They're both very sad to start.
Oh yeah.
Very sad.
I mean,
incredibly
that's
sad.
It's Pixar's move. Think about just across the board. Bugs Life, they just make fun of
Nemo's mom. Nemo's mom.
Without any respect.
Nemo's mom and, I don't know, 600 brothers and sisters just die immediately in the beginning.
Okay, yeah. Spoiler.
Yeah, no, that's how it starts. Yeah,
that's in the first minute. It's not a spoiler.
Frozen.
Please
continue.
You ever seen Bambi, dude?
What? Bambi.
Yeah, as a child,
Lion
I don't
King,
think I caught
Cinderella,
on.
Fairly
have you seen Coco?
Lion King.
You seen Coco?
Yeah, I've seen Coco.
Yeah,
they're
Lion
all
King
very
is
sad.
Hamlet.
Lion King.
I mean, Up.
Up. Oh my god!
I've never
up
seen
is
Up.
Such a bummer.
It opens up like, "Hey, look, this old guy's happy. He's had a great life. Just kidding. His wife just fucking died.
Yeah, look at his life. It's been really, really
see, but like,
nice."
Despicable Me and Minions aren't that sad.
No, not Pixar though.
No, yeah.
Okay.
So that's like the caveat for Pixar movies is that it will start incredibly depressing.
Yeah, like Frozen's like, oh, you can't talk to your sister anymore because you almost killed her, and oh, both your parents died, and you've been locked away in this room for 6 years.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. I feel like they move fast through it in Frozen, at least.
They do. I mean, you watch the ship capsize.
Go down.
Yeah.
You do.
It does go
just
by
in the ocean, and you just never see it
true
again.
You never see him again.
Wreck-It Ralph, I can't stress enough.
Also,
so fucking
Elsa's
good.
Not the star.
No.
Who is?
Are you talking
her
about
sister.
Well, Anna.
Queen Anna.
Yeah,
Anna. Princess Anna.
What about Olaf?
I like
Olaf. Yeah,
that's
Olaf.
I've actually
reindeer's a dog.
Oh, you should. It's good. Are you going to watch Frozen 2?
Seen Frozen?
There's a Frozen too.
I have not. Oh, you seen Frozen, Gus?
Oh yeah.
Nick, bro, it's a quick watch.
There's a Frozen 3 coming.
You're like hour 15. You're done.
That's how. That's how much I love them.
You should watch it.
Have you seen Zootopia?
No.
If you're in these movies with your daughter,
just crushing them.
Zootopia will dominate.
Zootopia has an absolute banger Shakira song.
Is that the one with the sloth?
Yes.
Working at the DMV.
Bingo.
Yes.
That's good. Zootopia is good.
Better than Waka Waka. Ha 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 ha. Hey hey. Waka waka wa. Hey hey. Better than that. Also, Jason Bateman is the main fucking character.
Now we go. I'm so excited.
Yeah. I'm pretty pumped for you.
I'm living life again. I've seen a lot of them.
You have Disney Plus. Yeah. So just go to the Pixar tab and just
trust me, friend. That's what I've been doing.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I am jealous.
I fired up a new look on Apple TV. Pretty good show.
You need to know this, that he for the first time got Apple TV last week, so he's got many undiscovered shows.
I had it for a while.
He's got unlimited Napoleon watches.
And I actually don't even remember canceling it, so I guess free trial.
I tried Napoleon and couldn't do it.
I got halfway through.
I haven't tried it yet. Yeah.
Oh,
I couldn't fucking do it.
I actually hate Napoleon.
I'm going to come back and finish it.
But. Bro, I did the exact same thing. I watched the first 40 minutes. Dude. The movie absolutely does suck.
Guys, you just don't love American history then.
Fucking Madame
Bonaparte. It's not American history.
Madame Bonaparte.
It is the precursor.
Madame Bonaparte's
American
getting slayed by some other dude.
Not fucking American.
Without the French Revolution, we wouldn't be sitting in the United States. Like we are right now.
Why must you do this to me?
I didn't really give a fuck because I couldn't get through the first 30 minutes.
Did have massive implications on the American Revolution.
Yeah.
What's the guy's name?
Joaquin Phoenix.
Yeah, so he's also the Joker, and he talks to a girl, and like I can't get the Joker out of my head while I'm watching.
You ever seen Gladiator?
That's actually fair.
It's pretty fucking creepy.
That's actually fair.
Joaquin Phoenix is kind of a weird, like, because
I nice looking.
See, the whole time I was just thinking it was Johnny Cash that was leading the army, and I was like, this is fucked.
No, that's the guy that fucked his phone.
Why isn't he singing Ring of Fire? What the fuck?
See, it's always Gladiator. It's always Gladiator for me. Yeah.
No,
I was just thinking, like, this is the Joker. This dude's creepy.
I kind of agree, though, because I don't think that the Napoleon was like that, like, mercurial as Joaquin Phoenix kind of portrays him. I think Napoleon was more like, I'm short, fuck you, fire the cannons.
Yeah,
you
know? DeVito should have played Napoleon.
That'd be sick. Been
boom. Awesome.
Come on.
25 Miss. Years ago, he would have.
Miss.
That would have been.
Also, awesome. Bruce just reminded me, new Apple TV show, Constellation.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
Did I talk about this last week?
You know, they haven't paid. I don't know if you got your check from Apple. Yet to
Constellation. It is a very interesting show. Very tough to follow.
That one intimidated me. I watched the trailer.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You're not my mother.
It is the most confused I've been throughout a show.
Is that Octopus show no good?
I watched that on Netflix. Octopus. I managed to make it through all 4 episodes. Just a massive letdown.
Really?
Carter, you would like it, I think.
Octopus.
It's about murder and conspiracies.
Yes.
On Netflix?
Yes.
So this is where it starts. Some guy in like the late 70s develops this software that can track.
Is this a true story?
Yes. They can track and creates a database of criminals. So court cases, and it's basically a criminal database.
Sure.
Yeah.
And the U.S. government, the Department of Justice, gets very interested in it. Somehow, some way, the company gets torpedoed, but now other governments are using it, blah, blah, blah. Mm. This thing goes all the way to the White House.
What?
People are dying, but it doesn't wrap up with any sort of real conclusion.
Oh.
Okay, good.
It goes into a little bit about the guy who did all the digging on the dirt and how he died, and you don't really get a real answer there. Like, it's a lot of open-ended shit.
They almost roped me in with the preview. It was pretty.
You could try it, but I would not recommend.
There it is.
Oh yeah, reading into this, Jesus, crucial quote.
Yeah,
it's all over the place too.
Joe, I'm scared. He said, I have been getting threatening calls. Why don't you get off this story? Friends ask. I can't, Joe. It's too deep.
We're talking CIA. We're talking deep state.
It's bigger than anything I've ever encountered. Like. Yeah, okay. This does look interesting. And if there was no real ending, that means they're still using it.
Oh, see?
My God.
I think Connor would be into it, but it's a tough follow, too.
Yeah, I'll give it a run. There's so many things right now I still have to watch.
Oh, dude, I actually did just watch a good movie. I turned off Napoleon, and I watched this movie, Damn Damsel? What the fuck?
Damsel with Millie Bobby Brown.
Yeah, I think so. It's on Netflix. It's on Netflix and
just came out.
It's pretty corny, like to start, to be honest. It's like a kind of seems like a corny princess movie, kind of like a Disney movie, but it's actually not. You have to let it kind of roll.
Okay.
Got to roll with it for like 45 minutes at least, and then it gets really, really fucking good. There's like dragons and shit. It's pretty cool.
So basically, there's like this royal family, and the prince of the royal family, this is what I gained from the trailer. The prince of royal family falls in love with Millie Bobby Brown, and they're like, hey, you guys are going to get married. Let's go to the thing. Yeah, I'm
set up.
Yeah.
Whoa.
I'm getting there, man. No.
I'm
getting there. And they go up to the mountain where the dragon lives, and instead of them getting married, they fucking throw her down the pit to sacrifice to the dragon.
Oh, they have that in the trailer?
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah. I didn't know that I could say that. Didn't watch the trailer, obviously.
Oh,
yeah. Fucking awesome movie.
And then it's fucking amazing. Millie Bobby Brown, basically.
Poor guy.
It's one of those movies you watch the trailer and you see the movie. Millie Bobby Brown fucking doesn't... I don't know if she slays a dragon, if she befriends a dragon.
Before we get to the plot, I just got to make sure I get this out, okay? There's a new season of Guy Fieri's Tournament of Champions. Just came out.
Nice.
Okay, 32 of the best chefs in the world.
Good to know.
Compete in a bracket.
Is he still doing diners?
No.
I saw a tweet.
I think it's just Guy's Grocery Games and the Tournament of Champions.
Saw a tweet. He was going down to Haiti.
Yeah.
I didn't know if that was.
Okay. Saw that, too. I didn't know that. And the new season of Rock the Block. I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with that.
Walk of Flava?
Dwayne Johnson show?
No, it's on... they take, like, four couples from... what network is it? That, like, do house renovation shows?
HGTV.
HGTV. They take, like, four of the best... And they give them all four the exact same houses. And at the end, whoever has the best house, like highest appraisal.
I like that.
That's sick.
It's a cool show.
You like those shows?
It's called Rock the Block.
Rock the Block.
Okay.
What's it on?
It'll be cool. Yeah.
And the winner gets to name the street.
Is it on?
That's a house. Is on HGTV. Yeah.
That's pretty cool. HGTV?
I do watch a lot of HGTV. Yeah.
That sounds fucking sick.
What's wrong with HGTV?
What's that?
What's wrong with HGTV?
Nothing. I got the wish I said.
When I need something like just to like. Fucking zone out.
Yeah.
Fucking, you show me someone redoing their kitchen. Yeah. Oh,
I used to watch a lot of. I used to always watch
Tiny Homes.
Tiny Homes.
Yeah,
it's good.
Yeah.
So basically, they would take like the whoever does Tiny Homes, the star of Tiny Homes, and three other shows on HGTV.
Todd Pennington and his crew.
I was gonna say Extreme Home Makeover.
Yeah.
Who were those?
Good morning, Johnson family.
Would you boy?
Property Brothers.
Someone in my town.
Canadian. Would you like
got the Extreme Home Makeover?
No way.
Hold in my town.
Hold on. Hold on. Would you like to hear who hosts Rock the Block?
Don't say Ty Pennington.
It's Ty Pennington.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Oh, shit. Wow. Well, this story isn't going to help. Someone in my town got the Extreme Home Makeover.
Mm-hmm.
The daughter of the family had a disease. And she was wheelchair bound, and they did the whole renovation, everything. There's like an elevator in the house, the whole thing. First time they go in, she gets stuck on the elevator in the house. So from then on, I was like, "Oh, this is a fucking joke. This isn't real." What is that? The photo?
Is that Ty Pennington?
Jason Mraz? Yes,
That's Ty Pennington, baby.
Does he have a hat on? He's wearing a hat.
Oh, yeah. He's wearing the Jason Mraz.
He's still wearing the
Ty Pennington's outfits are off.
He's wearing the Jason Mraz 1920s crooner hat.
Yeah. And he's rocking it.
Yeah, the barbershop
always
quartet
rocking
hat.
Just like he's rocking the block.
Yeah.
Know who else is rocking it?
Who?
Factor Meals.
Hell yeah, they are.
Eating better is easy with Factor's delicious, ready-to-eat meals. Every fresh, never-frozen meal is chef-crafted, dietitian-approved, and ready to go in just 2 minutes. You'll have over 35 different options to choose from every week. That's including Calorie Smart.
What?
Protein Plus.
What?
And Keto. Also, there are more than 60 add-ons to help you stay fueled up and feeling good all day long.
Yeah.
What are you waiting for? Get started today and get after your goals. Mitt, you have been crushing these Factor meals every
day.
Oh
yeah, Mitt.
Oh yeah.
What's your favorite?
Way to sell it, Mitt.
Yeah, what'd you eat today?
Today I had like it's like a beef and rice bowl. I don't know.
Ooh.
They have a lot of different
not the biscotti bowl.
A lot of different options. I love the beef and rice one. I love the chicken marsala. No one does it better as far as frozen chicken marsala goes than Factor.
Definitely not in Italy.
No chance. They also have pancakes, smoothies, and more. Discover a wide variety of easy options for the entire day, like breakfast, midday bites, obviously lunch, and dinner. No prep.
Yes.
No mess meals.
Yes.
None.
Factor meals are ready to heat and eat, so there's no prepping, cooking, or cleanup needed. Head to factormeals.com/thepod, THEPOD 50, and use code thepod50, THEPOD 50, to get 50% off today. Factormeals.com/thepod50.
No. Tell them we want the spaghetti bolognese back, too.
They got flapjacks on there?
They got flapjacks.
They are very good. They're good. They're good meals.
Yeah, fire.
Thank you, Factor Meals. I think we've rambled on about stuff no one cares about long enough. Let's get to what everyone came here for.
Yeah.
The fog.
Come on.
Hey-o.
Woo.
It needs to be said, Sydney Sweeney's boobs are not that big, says at Slate and the community notes, which has been on fire lately.
Yeah.
With a simple but precise nuke just fired back. Yes, they are.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you to whoever did this.
Listen, at Slate, don't try to attack America's sweetheart right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, don't do it. And also, what fucking horny bastard got this?
Her boobs aren't big enough. Need them bigger. Yeah.
Well, damn it.
Some son of a bitch.
Well, they're not.
Watching
they're not.
Yeah, they're not as big as Tits Hemingway from Harold and Kumar too, but whose are?
Yeah, exactly. That's a movie.
People are a real person.
What was one of the comments like, yeah, they're not big male callers.
Big rig haulers, yeah. I believe was the terminology.
Yes.
Yeah. There are some real big rig haulers that are offended by this, but I think for the general layman, I think they are big enough.
Yeah. I mean, her boobs are that big. What isn't big are her acting chops, because I watched anyone but you.
Good.
Oh, no, it was a good movie.
You better be careful talking about America's Sweetheart like this.
She was by far the worst part of the movie.
What?
But, I mean, acting-wise, all her lines. But, I mean, everything Ty said was true. Powell is the guy.
The charisma.
The dad.
Machismo.
Personally, the Australian dad steals the show. I thought he was the funniest one.
Is he the tip of the penis guy?
No. That is a different guy.
Can't wait to watch it.
Powell's ex's boyfriend, also great. Gata.
Yeah,
unbelievable.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, boy, I watch movies that Sydney Sweeney are in. But it makes sense why Madam Web fucking bombed.
That wasn't her fault.
No, it wasn't. But it definitely had something to do with her.
But also, what's her name said? I should not be in a role like this.
Dakota Johnson.
Dakota Johnson. Yeah. She also, I believe, acting chop wise,
not great.
May not.
Well, they just need to stop making fucking Spider-Man movies without Spider-Man in them.
I agree.
Because that ain't working.
Yeah. I don't think it's in here, but I actually saw that Spider-Man. That Sam Raimi basically said, "I'm gonna fucking get this thing."
Yeah, we're doing it.
In there.
They're also okay. Perfect.
So we can skip over it later.
Do we have Venom in there? Because speaking of Spider-Man movies,
Venom 2. I told you, I watched it last week.
Venom 3 is coming out.
What?
Yeah, the last chapter. Or something.
The last dance.
The last dance. There it is.
Really, George. Just on those. They just really fucking.
Yeah. Hey, we're done after this.
People like the
Michael Bill sent in a nude.
Oh, jeez, Tony.
Good Lord.
Claimed actor Stellan Skarsgård talked about how he spent 8 hours a day in the makeup chair.
Is this Skarsgård's dad?
Yes, it is.
In real life?
Yeah.
And the other Skarsgård.
Bill Skarsgård.
Yeah, both of them.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Oh,
I love
incredible family Skarsgård. Of Norwegians.
Yeah.
They're,
Swedes, maybe?
I believe Swedes.
I don't like the Skarsgård that was in Succession.
Oh, you don't?
Really?
No, that's Alexander.
Maybe I just didn't like his character.
I think he's pretty sweet.
Okay.
Yeah, he's good in a lot of stuff.
I've only ever seen him in Succession, I feel like. So
Bill Skarsgård's the one.
That we don't like?
I love Bill Skarsgård.
He's Pennywise.
He's Pennywise.
Yeah. He's a fucking
beast. Something else, too. He did something else that was good.
I mean, obviously, Stellan's the fucking king.
Yeah.
Professor Jerry Lambeau.
He is the monarch. He is the patriarch of the family. Yeah. And as you can see here.
Bill Skarsgård is Joe Burrow.
Yeah,
basically.
Yeah.
Looks just like
he was just in something else that he was really good in. Bill Skarsgård. What's his
Bill?
What does his cinephile say?
Let me look at Bill.
As far as recent, because he
John McFour.
Boom. Yeah. There it is.
There it is. He was
the bad
guy. The Marquis.
The Marquis de Fleury or something.
Crush that.
De Maldu. Jonathan. You need to kill the Marquis, Jonathan.
That show's gonna suck, by the way. Do we get cool frontal like this in Dune 2?
No, no cool frontal like that, but believe me, you get plenty of him.
Best tweet of this picture was...
that's where I got it from.
Yeah, yep. Me on Sunday watching golfers shank the ball.
Say, nice shot, dipshit.
Yeah, exactly.
Those are the best. There's also one of him standing up that is fucking awesome. Mason Rudolph to Tennessee.
Yeah.
It's fucking awesome.
Tennessee's loading up.
I tried to put together a tweet with this and the
you just don't have
costume anymore, sign yeah. for mm-hmm. John Cena, and it just didn't come together. We're moving on. At Empty Testicles retweeted this article about a deli painter who got his hands back after an organ donation. Both of his hands were replaced in a transplant, and he said, the first thing I would do is crank my hog again. And it's really hard to dispute
that
sentiment.
I thought this was Ty's burner. I was like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
Gotcha, Ty.
Yeah.
We know. I mean,
who's to say you wouldn't? That probably is.
It's hard to argue that you wouldn't.
I mean, I'm sure... During his physical therapy to get like the feeling back in his hands, all he's thinking about during it is like, I just got to put in the hours now so I can crank my hog once I get my motor function
or
back.
Or it could be like the PT could tell him, hey, go home and just fucking have at it because that's going to be the best.
What if that was his PT?
PT, yeah.
Yeah. Listen, every 35 minutes, whip the penis out, get it hard, crank your hog.
At first, it's
the only way.
It's going to feel like somebody else is jerking you off. So at you're first, really going to enjoy it.
Forever. Those aren't his arms.
We don't know that. I didn't read the article. But I thought, you know how we talked about that guy that grew the penis on his arm?
Yep.
Yeah.
What if they grew both of these arms off of his penis?
Could have happened.
Is that guy still going?
Or like, or like his ass cheeks. Like this guy was just walking around with two arms on his ass cheeks. Couldn't sit down for a year while he's growing his butt cheeks.
It looks like
if you had to grow arms off of me, I'd want them off the back of my knees. Okay, so I could lock into the ground with my feet and arms.
Like the guy from Jury Duty,
yeah.
Who had the crutch seat.
Fucking locked
fucking
in.
Call you Groot, dude. If you were on
Bingo.
That'd be sick,
Bingo.
Actually. Being able to just kick up your kickstand.
Yeah.
Be nice.
That would be cool.
It looks like he may have pooped him out and he grew the hands inside his gut if the first picture is any indication.
Yeah, there's a chance because he does look much thinner. I would want them on. I'd want General Grievous. I want right under the ribs.
Yeah.
You know, like, so then I
fucking
like
Goro and Goro. Yeah.
Boom. That's who I was thinking.
I like that we could do this now. I didn't know this was an option.
They need to figure out some way to make the connection point look a little better.
It'll get there.
It'll heal. That was right after.
Yeah, that's day one.
Summertime. He'll go out, get a nice tan. It'll all even out.
You're probably right.
He should just get huge tattoos on both sides.
Like massive clumps of hair.
Yeah.
All of his arm.
Definitely possible. What if he did, dude, just get a tattoo that said, like, old arm, new arm? Like, that'd be cool.
That'd be sweet. I'd like that.
Cut here.
Or got the globe and had the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere.
Here we go. Now we're getting somewhere.
This is gross.
Maybe Mason a mountain.
Mason Dixon.
It's beautiful, Mitt.
Of course it's gross.
He's got a second chance, brother.
Yeah, of course it's disgusting.
He can paint again.
Okay.
And crank his hog again.
And make sandwiches.
Oh, he was a painter.
Yes.
Yeah. His gift.
Yeah, he didn't work in a deli, Tony. He's from deli.
That's how I read that one for sure.
Yeah. He's from deli.
Deli painter.
this guy just
goes around.
He's so good at making sandwiches.
Guy can't make home sandwiches anymore.
Thought he was so good at making sandwiches that his nickname was the fucking deli painter. Fucking Picasso of fucking salami.
You son of a bitch.
The bread is his canvas.
Subway Savant.
Look at that shit-eating grin on his face. That is of a man who's
cranked his hog.
God, fucking I'm going to page 5,000 on Pornhub when I get home.
Cannot wait.
What's next? Okay, this is a...
we're already in the video portion?
This is a Japanese game show.
This is a good gimmick.
Where you have to serve food and drink in a slanted room. If we
can...
Great gimmick.
Why are they so good
at game shows?
At game good. Japan is so good at game shows.
Japan's never been hotter.
No.
In my life.
I love the guy saying,
I I can watch this show for hours.
How does it take out the people on the far right?
Like, it's slanted, dude. You get knocked off your fucking
I need to see a successful attempt. I need to see a win at that game.
Yeah.
How's it done?
I agree.
That would be nice.
Uh-oh. Oh, Bill.
What?
Bill.
There appears to be quite the controversy happening.
He's coming.
With Beal's favorite coffee.
This was circulating years ago, and I believe
Tony's
I had believed it to be debunked, but here it is. Okay, back
again. It is back in the mix.
Come to the saloon.
Beal, what is going on with Black Rifle Coffee? It's taken a lot of heat, I see, in the political realm.
Currently, there's some way that you can research like where these organizations get their money from, the political organizations, and there's one that's very Democrat, left leaning. That is getting a bunch of...
have you denounced your...
your allegiance?
Your allegiance to the Black
Rifle? House Black Rifle?
I still enjoy the coffee. I think it's a good coffee.
Have you denounced...
I still like beer.
Have you denounced your allegiance?
I have not.
Son, Bill, and House also, Rifle.
I have also not given my allegiance.
Okay. I
have a lot of merch. I have not worn the hat in a while. Those camo shirts are really fucking cool. I'm going to wear those shirts no matter what. But
you're
a people are
liberal, damn it.
People are mad about all this.
Well, just keep us updated on your allegiance, okay?
Yeah, will do.
Bill, I'm going to need you to put on a Black Rifle t-shirt, get that Black Rifle hat on,
okay?
Get a jug of Black Rifle coffee, walk to your fucking hometown of Shelbyville, and you tell me what they do.
The good news is no one there is media literate enough to know what Twitter is, so they don't know what's happening.
I don't know.
Probably just move on.
Anytime closet liberals are going pro-vet, pro-gun, pro-American, usually doesn't matter. If you are, you know, media or technology advanced.
I don't know much about Black Rifle. I think they do a lot of good for the soldiers and the vets, so... Yeah, hats off to them.
Hats off.
Well, it sounds like it sounds like they're not actually.
It's next.
Not pro vet. It's not pro American.
What's next?
Mitt said this in, by the way.
Oh, okay.
2 minutes before the show, he said, has to be in the fog.
He's right. Applebee's and IHOP have quietly been serving pancakes and wings at a single restaurant for the past 6 years.
What does that mean?
Okay, so I went into this article. I was obviously just taken aback when I first read the
gobsmack.
Headline. Gobsmack. Yeah, absolutely
gobsmack.
And you guys would never guess what bad, shitty fucking town that they are doing this in.
What are they
Shelbyville, Indiana.
Nope, it is not. And also, we do have somebody in the office to blame. They're doing it in Detroit.
Oh.
Foxy knew about this, didn't tell any of us.
Wait, I don't understand what's going on.
Yeah. Fuck, so it's an Applebee's. It's literally an Applebee's and IHOP.
Like under the same roof?
And IHOP under the same fucking roof. If it's open 24 hours, I need to get some fucking wings. I need to get some fucking pancakes.
Word on the street is this only exists in Detroit. And you can tell us that Mitt wants to slit your throat because of it.
They're saying that Applebee's and IHOP have quietly been serving pancakes and wings at the single restaurant. I've never seen that.
I don't know what it means, by the way.
Lying.
Sounds like there's one building that is an Applebee's, but
like
it's also an IHOP.
Taco Bell?
Bingo.
I kind of like that.
I've never seen it. I wouldn't surprise me if it existed. I would definitely go. But yeah, where I'm from, I've never seen
that. By the way, have you downtown boys been to the cantina yet?
Ooh, no. We did walk by it.
The Taco Bell cantina downtown.
We walked by it when we hiked.
Taco Bell that serves alcohol.
When we hiked from the slam dunk contest to 16-bit. In like -5
what?
Degrees.
I don't remember walking by it.
We passed the cantina as our legs were beginning to
pay your dues and make that walk. That's a walk that has to be.
Oh, we did. Yeah.
Where the fuck is the cantina that we walked by? I don't remember
on
that.
On the way to 16-bit from Lucas Oil. That's
look,
all I know.
I heard you fucking say that. I'm saying on
holy
that walk.
Shit,
we turned right and it was to the left.
Where it's by.
We turned right, it was to the left.
We turned right. It was to the left.
So it's to the left.
We didn't walk straight by it.
No, it's.
He's not gonna like that.
It's uptown a bit.
Just north of Kilroy's and shit.
Whoa!
What happened?
Bill Levis lands another absolute weapon.
Dude, the Titans got Calvin Ridley.
Well, I think he saw Mason.
Is that what put it over the?
Yeah, it was.
Holy shit! They were the mystery team.
And he. Do you think Calvin Ridley was just waiting to know, see where Mason was going?
Sounds
There's
like
a chance. It. You guys beat the Jags, right?
No, we lost.
All right, fuck this.
What's next?
I don't see why that's that big of a deal.
No, me yeah, no.
I don't know why they're so pissed about that. Like
it. Yeah, me either.
Because it's
probably strip mall.
It's not in anywhere else. Like, yeah, that would be the number one fucking...
It's not restaurant. Natural. Just you some need to savvy real estate developer got two and two and put them together, brother.
Great bar yeah, sign. Well, they need to
fucking
is.
Do that here. I want this, is, the Pike one.
This is a big deal. Steven Spielberg confirms Ready Player 2 is in development.
Yes!
Because
yes!
Ready Player 1 took a long time to get out.
Yes!
But it did well.
Fantastic news. I mean, this is one of my favorite, I wouldn't say video game movies because it, you know, like it's kind of a video game movie, but it's also just like, hey, this is how the world works. What me and Zeet were talking about, because me and Zeet, this is one of those movies where at the pub, if it was on TV, we were putting it on, we were sitting there and watching it. We just don't understand like where the plot goes because at the end they lock up.
Oh, you don't think Spielberg is going to find it out?
No. I'm sure. I have complete faith.
I think Spielberg's going to find it out.
That's why I'm excited because I have faith. I'm just saying I don't know like where they go with it.
Oh, he's going to find the plot.
The main character is the richest guy in the world.
I was going to say they gave him the...
Everything.
Yeah.
The Oasis.
The Oasis. That's what
But what do they do? I'm assuming there must be some sort of like bug battle inside of it where there's some bug trying to destroy the entire thing and they create a virus and it's eating the world and the players.
You might have just found
the plot.
cracked it.
And then they have to go in and stop it and there's some huge battle at the end of all the bugs that have eaten players.
Do you think TJ Miller is going to be in this one?
I think so. He's making a comeback.
Yeah, he was in something recently that I saw.
Was he?
Yeah, prison, I think, right? No.
He was doing stand-up in Vegas on billboard. I saw that.
That's where I saw it. Yeah. Thank you.
So maybe, but I think they might pass on him, go for a different...
different funny man?
Different funny fat dudes. Josh Gad, I could see.
You know what they need to do? Get rid of fucking Ty Sheridan or whatever the kid whose name is. Get rid of him. Hire Glenn Powell.
Dude.
Sorry.
Wade what?
Yeah, sorry.
Isn't Ty Sheridan the creator of Yellowstone?
That's Taylor Sheridan.
I think he combined Ty Pennington and Taylor.
No, there is definitely an actor named Ty Sheridan. I believe he was in the critically acclaimed film Mud with Matthew McConaughey. I cannot remember if it's the kid in this movie.
Okay.
I didn't love the first one. I thought it was kind
of
pop culture.
Yeah.
It's pop culture.
Oh, you want to see the Iron Giant battle the T-Rex from Jurassic Park? Here you go.
Yeah, I do. And even with that voice, yeah, I do. I do want to see that happen. This is going to be sick.
What's next? This guy announced that his concert in Connecticut has been postponed, and I don't know if it's accurate or not, but it was reported that this is the guy who shot Ronald Reagan.
Is it?
And he has had a series of concerts be announced and be postponed. John Hinckley?
It is. No, it is.
Okay, this is the same man who fired a shot at Ronald Reagan.
Or it's some guy just trolling on Twitter with his picture, but it's certainly him. This guy, if you go to his Twitter, is also a tremendous artist. He has a painting that he was selling on eBay of just some big rig haulers, just an actual...
He dabbles in the erotic arts.
Actual painting of just gigantic boobs. Okay. So I'm all in on this guy. I hope he gets that.
What a fascinating life.
Oh, songwriting, performance, and art is in his Wikipedia, so...
He's a bit of a Renaissance man, then.
Yeah, he really is. Checking all the
boxes.
Correct
me if I'm wrong.
Go on.
Or bid me adieu.
Yep, I will bid you adieu.
Or enlighten me.
There it is.
When he shot Ronald Reagan, did Ronald Reagan die?
No.
Okay.
Survived the assassination.
Was this the one where the Secret Serviceman took the bullet?
Yes.
Okay.
It was. He was attempting to impress True Detective Season 4 co-star Jodie Foster, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
I remember that now. Yeah. That's a bona fide.
Yeah.
What a weirdo.
Bingo.
I'm a creep.
He wrote that, actually.
He did.
Yeah, he did.
And, but, you know, maybe one of these days he'll get a show off the ground.
Yep.
What's next?
This is, like, truly a heartbreak.
Yeah, this is really tough to stomach. Nicolas Cage says there is no National Treasure 3, and then... delivers a fucking gut punch. Just boom. If you want to find treasure, don't look at Disney. It's not there.
Jesus. Banger. Someone needs to put that in a rap song.
Yeah.
Like, immediately.
Or on a shirt.
What the show do on Disney Plus? I know Zeke was watching
it. Stunk.
Yeah,
probably about as good as the Mighty Ducks one.
Anytime
Nick the Stick,
if Zeke watches a show like National Treasure, especially because that scratches all where we itch, including him.
Zeke,
and I believe Zeke when he first started watching was like,
Zeke,
it's okay. If you get an it's okay from Zeke, you know it's a bad show.
You're right.
You know, because he won't say anything is bad. And I also have that problem with some things.
And I'm not going to give up hope. I sense this is just frustration from, you know, dealing with some big corporate business.
This is Cage putting pressure on Disney.
Yeah.
This is a negotiating
tactic. He needs to make another motorcycle movie.
Ghost Rider? Johnny Blaze?
He crushed the best actor speech that everyone gave. Yeah, it actually was incredible.
Him and Giamatti, baby.
Yeah.
Heard he was blind in one eye.
No one's crazy enough to do that. Oh, wait, I am.
So awesome.
What's next?
Your money got robbed, by the way.
Dev Patel broke his hand, two toes, tore his shoulder, and got an eye infection throughout filming Monkey Man.
What's Monkey Man?
Yes.
Yeah,
I've seen a lot about it.
So Monkey Man is very similar to a John Wick-esque movie. Okay.
Looks like it.
Also saw something else that makes it even more appealing. Allegedly, this is a Netflix film. Jordan Peele watched it. Said, oh, no.
Take it to.
Bought it and then is now releasing it in theaters because of how good
it was.
That's
a cool movie.
Yeah.
That's a great
movie. Wait, so he got pink eye?
Well,
eye infection. He probably, he got
stabbed in his eye with a switchblade.
There was like a 2 minute or a minute 30 video of like a sequence in the movie. And it's Patel walking. And the reason it's Monkey Man is because he wears a monkey mask.
Yeah. Is it in the kitchen?
Oh,
yeah.
So that,
bingo.
He did get
that.
Pink eye from his monkey mask.
The monkey mask is early. He like uses that because he's like a street fighter and he becomes the Monkey Man. And then I believe he just goes on a tear.
Yeah. I think like someone killed his mom or something.
Oh,
yeah.
So it's a tale of vengeance.
It is John Wick. But
John
monkey
Wick,
man.
Old boy. That movie where the guy goes through
the Punisher.
The Punisher, the apartment complex where they just fight after
Hellboy.
Fight after fight.
Kind
after
of the
fight.
Bourne trilogy.
A little bit.
Hellboy?
The Bourne trilogy is a journey of a man trying to figure out who he is. That is not.
Yes, brother, but he's still on a path.
We're talking
of,
Ron Perlman
of,
Hellboy or DK Harbor Hellboy?
Vengeance, ultimately.
Ron Perlman.
Hellboy. Okay.
Bruce, I'll give you $50 if you can tell me what Jason Bourne's real name is right now.
Fuck.
Ethan,
hold on.
Brian,
I think I
something.
Have it.
No,
wrong.
It's not.
What's it start with? What's the letter?
Is it Elliot? No,
nope.
What's Cox's name?
Oh, you. I think you might have the last.
I
name.
I have the last name. I know. That's why I'm.
I can't remember.
First name starts with a D.
David.
Bingo.
David Elliott.
Close. David Webb.
David
right.
Webb. Just like the quarterback.
D-Webb.
I had David ready. Webb. My guess was Elliot Wolf. So you know where my head was at. Fucking prick.
Yeah, fuck.
100% on Rotten Tomatoes is no joke.
No joke, Monkey Man. Brother.
Oh, yeah. Definitely watch a Monkey Man.
What's next?
Monkey Man. They should have a song.
This is from at Baseball History Nut. It's actually at Nut History. George Fatty Hackett was the world's largest baseball player ever documented at 450 pounds. He played for the 1908 Citizens baseball team in good old PA.
Yeah. Look, this is not a shot. This is just strictly an observation. Can you zoom in on the face, please?
This kid looks 12 years old.
This kid,
I know where you're going with this.
He's got, he does, right?
And I'm seeing it.
He's got a lot of Caboli.
He does.
And that's just the bottom line. Like that has,
he does.
That has nothing to do with the guy. Like this is not
size.
A fat joke. He,
yeah, no,
actually,
he actually
looks like Mark Caboli.
Might be distant relative.
I was going to say, does he have a great-grandmother with the last name Hackett?
We'll have to dig in and find out.
Boom. Bill, walking through the gym, just asked, is that Caboli?
That
it's,
is.
It's, yeah, it's certainly the dumbfound squint that lends itself to the appearance of Caboli.
Yep, the eyes, you know, sharp like a hawk.
Sure, the gullet as well.
How do we know if this guy would last a day in Pittsburgh?
Yeah, we need to see where in PA Caboli is from. I mean, this guy would bunt and hit a home run.
Well, he had to because with that fucking ginormous fupa, he was not running the base. Yeah, that guy's getting thrown out from left
I'd
field.
I'd like to see
first base.
This guy in the Fanatics unis.
Me
you know
too.
What I mean?
Good luck.
This is the guy from Moneyball.
Okay.
Didn't even realize he hit a home run. He's that guy.
Tripped over. Right. Was tripped second, over first or second
first base. Everyone's laughing at him. Oh.
Oh.
That's the thing, Billy.
What's next?
Get 500 feet over the fence.
Shogun will likely not get a season two.
Goddamn savages!
We spoke about Shogun
Why
earlier.
Why am I doing that?
There's only one book, and the whole first season is the one book.
I'm okay with this.
It also...
They're not going to just make up some shit.
I don't need a George R. R. Martin situation.
I guess we can write off the greatest show of all time.
Yeah.
I didn't say Amen. That. I said the last 5 years.
It costs like $250 million to make, and it's been done for 2 years, and it's been in post-production, so I'm guessing we're getting some massive battle scene.
It is nice to think that the story will be finished at the
end. It's fine. It's like Detective.
They will finish their story.
Not everything needs to go five, six, seven,
eight. No.
And not everyone finishes their story.
A lot of people wish, you know, if like Homeland would have finished after one season. Of
Boom. Yeah, bingo.
No.
That would have been sick.
Homeland, after two seasons, maybe.
Homeland, two. But Homeland 1 is still one of my favorite.
I agree.
Oh, phenomenal.
I actually only watched the first season.
It's unbelievable.
They did Brody wrong.
Yeah.
Did you finish it?
No.
Homeland?
It got so bad.
No.
I just watched the first season.
I finished.
Carrie got too crazy.
Yep.
Dairy Queen sets next free cone day for the first day of spring.
Okay, get out there.
Free soft serve, boys.
Just wanted, this is more of a PSA.
When, okay. So March 21st?
It's coming up.
Sometimes we just do
what is the PSAs? The first day?
Excuse me.
I believe it is March 21st.
Okay.
Or is it April? I don't know.
No, usually March 21st is the spring solstice.
Yeah, okay. That's what I was looking for, the solstice.
Okay, thank you. By the way, I don't know if you guys know this, when I was getting my tattoo done, the artist told me because I'm Bill! The lunar eclipse, solar eclipse.
Sure.
I think it's happening on April 8th.
Solar, I believe, yeah.
Have you seen the path?
No.
That it's taking?
Yes.
Huh?
No.
Bill, did you know or hear? Apparently hotel rooms in Shelbyville, Indiana are going for like $2,000 a night.
Oh, yeah, for the eclipse.
Because that is in the entire world, that is the location that it will be visible the longest and most clear. So all the scientists and shit are buying all the hotel rooms in Shelbyville, Indiana.
Holy shit.
Which there are a lot because we built one casino and everyone loves to go to that casino.
Apparently it's
going to
be a beautiful site. I think it's April 8th.
That'll be sick for us then.
Yeah, I mean, we'll be able to see it here for sure.
It's happening here at like 3 p.m.
Selling their 3D glasses all marked up so you could look at it.
That'd be sweet.
3 p.m.?
Yeah, I believe it's like right at near... ish the end of the show.
Perfect. That is
don't awesome. Look directly at it.
You will go blind.
We tried to do this years ago and I used a cereal box.
Cereal box thing at the end.
It didn't work great for me.
No, but
you just glance at it, right?
I don't know. Yeah.
Anything longer you turn to stone.
Well, that's what I thought when I was a kid, so I didn't
thank
look.
You, Bill.
Yep.
You can just look at that.
Hell yeah.
How about you look at this? This company creates custom motorcycle helmets that look just like your actual face.
Ooh.
That does look just like that guy, I assume.
From the beard.
Kind of.
Yeah.
You don't motorcycle looks, helmets look kind of sweet?
Kind of looks like Mitt.
Yes. You wouldn't want it.
There like is just, Mitt in that guy.
Yeah.
Gubby, can you put... That's not a motorcycle helmet, but it's kind of a motorcycle helmet.
Be careful. Don't smudge the Dale Jr. autograph.
That baby gums.
Yeah, like you look super cool.
Yeah, that looks sick.
Boom, instantly cool.
Yeah, like I'd rather have this than my face.
You look really cool.
Legitimately.
Can you flip the visor up? Yeah.
Oh, there he is.
Oh my God.
There he is.
I might wear this for the rest of the show.
Should.
I think right, fucking
well,
sick.
I don't think you should because something happened.
Oh no.
Oh, okay.
Oh no.
System maintenance.
This might just be general system.
Oh, no. Zeet's looking over here,
there
too.
We're good.
Don't embarrass us, guys.
It's not a ruckus.
We're good.
Just general system.
I just saw the look of a concerned father over here. Like,
next.
What the hat?
What's next?
You think
Mitt, you should get one of those. The hair.
Mitt, why do you not have a crotch rocket?
Can you imagine Mitt going 150 miles an hour down Pendleton just
on a
running red lights? Yeah.
In his Mustang. In his Mustang, you mean?
Well,
with this on? Like a race car?
Yep. It'd
be sick.
I do need to get a new car.
Yeah.
I thought it was in the shop.
My actual car is in the shop.
Yeah, you don't need a new car.
You don't.
That key is sweet.
Yeah.
You should keep that.
Just,
safe.
What's next?
Something safe and sturdy.
Something safe and sturdy would be nice.
My car's safe.
Oh, is it? Okay, we got something here. What do we got?
This said, the tweet said, I apologize to Wile E. Coyote. I didn't know Roadrunners had it like that.
That's a real life Roadrunner. There's a good bit of speed there.
I mean, it gets up and goes.
He takes off.
Yeah, but that cat's got no speed.
Cat's dragging ass a little bit. That's not an impressive performance
that
by that
feline. Stinks.
That Roadrunner is fucking fast.
Yeah, shout out to the Roadrunner, if anything.
Oh, this guy's a beast. I know this guy. What's his name?
Fucking Laser Man.
This guy created, it's basically Cyclops. He created lasers that you control with your eyes.
Someone said, oh, cool, guys. We're watching an evil villain grow up, so we will stop this guy.
And I assume, you know, the laser's not super intense right now, but holy, I think he can dial that up a little bit.
He's controlling the laser with his eyeballs.
Hate to say it, we gotta kill this guy.
He shouldn't live.
No. What, I mean, yeah, harmless now. He's just shooting through fucking cardboard.
Yeah, I don't like the mirror setup either. That's dangerous.
Whoa!
He was surprised by that one.
He was surprised by that one.
I mean, this is pretty fucking cool.
You should buy this.
No, well, see, you can't do that.
I would fucking buy
can't
this.
Do
you
that.
Can't do that. You can't
he's
do this.
Kind of jocked, too, so this is problematic.
Yeah, this is like the guy from Iron Man. What's his name? The second movie?
Justin Hammer.
Yeah,
no, that's
oh, you're
Hammer.
Talking about
the guy with the
Mickey Rourke's Russian accent.
Mickey Rourke, bingo, there it is. That's who this guy reminds me of.
No,
just in the lab,
with
lab
like
shit.
That
yeah,
dad, doesn't he?
But,
what if Mickey Rourke and Iron Man combined with Mickey Rourke from The Wrestler?
See,
and Mickey Rourke from The Expendables.
Ivan.
Oh shit.
Then you'd have the best character of all time.
Yeah, you'd have an actual Superman.
Toll Road.
Come on.
Ivan Toll Road.
Yeah. Actually, I don't think his name was Toll
for
Road.
Sure, obsessed with Superman. He was wearing a Superman shirt, Superman on the backpack. He's fighting for good. He's not fighting for
no, he's certainly
spine.
Trying to kill Superman.
Superman's his fucking motivation.
I think this is Thailand, but they said they're putting
I saw this!
Full diesel engines on the back of these little boats and racing them.
We're talking like 120 horsepower, right? This thing's got some torque.
120. I think these are 600 Jesus. Horsepower.
Yeah, look at,
look at the size of that engine and how fast this thing goes.
Look at the boat.
Tons of diesels moving.
The tough part is, I think 250 people have died from crashing because if you do crash, it's immediate death.
Oh, immediate death.
That guy's a good engine.
We used to have a boat like this in the yard.
You guys just like hang this? Out on it, drink pints.
Did so you paint
when
it?
When there was like a touch up that had to be done when the boat was in the water, you'd take that out and you'd fucking big roll.
You
it.
Took that out to go paint? That's sick.
700 miles an hour.
Oh, you have a riff in the bay?
No, it had a bit of a. What are those boats called?
Whaler?
Or something. It had a fucking Skiff? Motor on it.
A dinghy?
No, it wasn't a dinghy.
Okay.
Like the ones that hang on the back of yachts.
Yeah, but faster.
Oh. Cigarette.
Like a whaler.
Is it probably a whaler?
I mean, I could. I was picturing rowboat.
No,
like,
no.
You gotta
had
be fucking kidding. No,
it was the best because it would always be a labor that would take you out on it. So you just sit in the boat until you got to the boat and you had to do the painting.
I like that.
God.
Nice cushy job.
I'm so glad you don't have to do that anymore. Jesus Christ.
All right, everybody. Shout out to Factor Meals.
Love you, Factor.
Thank you, Factor.
Sticking around with us. We appreciate
shout
that.
Shout out to SeatGeek. Shout out to SeatGeek.
Shout out to SeatGeek. Shout out to Bruce.
Shout out, Bruce.
Coordinating all the ads.
Shout out, Bruce.
Shout out, Bruce.
Had a baby, Bruce.
And,
love you, Bruce.
We'll see you next week.
Show. $30 off right now with Pat 30 at SeatGeek.
Snuck it in. Good luck, Mitt.